An Assassin's Creed game.
Yes.
Two, in fact, right? Chronicles of China? No.
Well, I don't know. Yeah, so I guess they could show the other two parts of Chronicles.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, I don't know. That seems kind of...
They'll probably do a trailer or something. Syndicate.
Syndicate?
Is the main thing.
Assassin's Creed Syndicate.
Yes, not the other Syndicate.
I'm sorry,
I got really confused.
Yeah, got really excited there for a second.
Sorry, Top Hat, Assassin's Creed.
Right.
Yeah. Division. The Division, Rainbow Six Siege.
Division?
The Division. I said The Division.
Rainbow Six Siege.
And then there's supposed to have some other stuff.
Beyond Good and Evil 2.
No. Yeah, that's been announced.
There will be a Just Dance.
Yeah, probably spend some time talking about a Just Dance.
A Ravage game?
They will say the word Rayman at some point.
You think so? Okay.
Yes, at least one mention.
Okay. Yeah. All right.
Far Cry.
Too soon.
Probably won't be there.
I
would hope not, honestly.
I've heard some stuff about a new Far Cry.
Yes, no. Watch Dogs 2.
I think
but
yes.
I don't think it'll be there.
Unfortunately, yes.
Maybe
it'll be too.
I do. Yes.
I don't think so.
I'm going to say even odds. I don't know.
I'm going to say yes.
So you're saying 50-50?
I've been wrong
That's
about everything
go.
So far.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Yes.
50-50.
I'm going to say maybe.
I'd say maybe. I'd say it could be there.
That's valid.
Yeah, no, I'm with you. I'll hedge my bet.
It could happen, but I think it's too soon, but it maybe.
But I'm not saying, like, hey, it's out this year. I'm saying, like, they're going to show a trailer and be like,
Aiden Pierce,
the protagonist that everyone remembers.
It only
by
shipped
name.
A year ago, and it left a bad taste in people's mouths. I feel like
the rumor
those
that
two
I heard,
things together.
Uh-huh.
They're ditching Aiden and going somewhere else. This
oh,
is complete
no
rumor
way.
Stuff. I know.
It takes
I know
place 20 years after that, and you play as the
after,
kid,
the
you play as his sister's
have
kid.
Won.
All right. Okay.
I heard it's a person of color. That's the thing I actually have heard. Like,
all right.
We'll see.
All right. Okay. And there'll be some, you know, some new announcements here, in addition to stuff that you are already aware of.
Whatever happened to
it's a bold prediction on my part, I know.
There could be stuff. Whatever happened to their like movie venture tie-in stuff? Remember that thing? Like,
like
Spielberg.
I wonder if they'll address anything non-gaming and be like, "Hey, the Assassin's Creed movie is still
That thing is supposedly still on track."
They
so
passed that.
They did. I want to say Fassbender was supposed to be in it.
Oh.
But I don't know. I forgot. I feel like there was some other casting stuff, but like Fassbender was the big one.
I feel like their conference usually has a leg that is like a part of it that is just like, whoa.
Laser tag.
How did we get here?
Right.
Asa Tyler?
I don't know. Yeah.
I think she's been confirmed.
Okay. Yeah,
I think
she's in the trailer.
Yeah. I think we're in. I think we're going.
All right.
Yeah, it's Fassbender and Marion Cotillard.
Oh, okay.
The relic reclaimed.
The Inception lady, right?
Is this them starting, or is this GameSpot still running some stuff here?
What?
Oh, Stick of Truth.
Wait. Are they doing another one?
No way.
No. What?
Oh, they are. Holy
fucking
shit.
Really?
I think Stick of Truth is going to show up in some form.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah. All right. Good. Good call. Going to do it bigger, and we will settle for nothing less than a 9-5 on GameSpot.
Dark Sorcerer has emerged. Who is it? That's an old joke. This is not the...
Oh, man, I have no idea. No, this is new, though. None of this footage.
Yeah.
None of this footage was in the last game.
They had the GameSpot joke in for the first game.
No, it wasn't in the game. It was in an interview.
It was in the trailer.
Okay.
Yeah, Trey Parker said something in the interview. Yeah.
Trey Parker, there was someone who worked for GameSpot that was tight with Trey Parker, which is the only reason that happens.
Okay. Yeah.
Ah, shit, we got the wrong game. Everybody switch games, we're playing superheroes now.
Oh, they're doing the superhero stuff.
Oh, they're changing
soon.
Oh.
Alright.
Yeah. Wow, okay.
This game take another decade now.
Right. Yep.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome two of my favorite
Rory
human beings
Cackle.
In the entire world, Matt
really
Stone
good.
And Trey Parker.
Oh, awesome. Holy crap.
While they're walking out, hey, you guys, are we going out to YouTube okay? I'm seeing a couple of reports that it's not showing up, but maybe they're looking at the wrong URL or something.
What's up? How are you guys doing?
Man.
First of all, I'd just like to say that these mics are fucking dumb.
Yeah, fuck, right?
Yeah.
Don't act like you don't wear those during sex every single night, my friend.
Look at
you. You guys look great. Come on.
Thank you.
You look like you're going to take my order. I want French fries. Supersize it. Yeah. First of all, the trailer for the game looks amazing. Are you guys excited about it?
Yeah.
It's weird because you don't seem like
I
you
guess.
Are.
Yeah.
And also, I feel
it's
like
these mics. That,
it's
know.
The mics that are
stiff. Yeah, the mics are throwing us, but
just
okay. Yeah, we don't know what to do with our hands.
Pockets or inside your pants.
Right.
I read that you guys, after the last game, said that you were never, ever, ever going to make another video game again.
That's true.
Hashtag
and,
the fractured butthole.
But then they offered us money.
The big thing is we're kind of whiny babies.
Mm-hmm.
And we just realized that at the end, right at the end of Stick of Truth, we mm-hmm. kind of learned how to make video games. And it was kind of too late.
Yeah.
And we're like, well, fuck, now we know how to make a good video game.
Yeah.
So we have a good template to do it. And we thought, fuck it, let's do it.
Yeah. Again. Yeah. Do it again.
Yeah, we might regret it, but we're doing it again. Yeah.
Look, I want to say,
knowing
you two, I don't think a fear of regret has ever kept you from doing anything. No. I think that has to be a
we've had some regrets.
Yeah, I'm saying just regrets, power through it. Now, who are you working with on this game?
We're working with Ubisoft San Francisco, and it's basically, obviously
is that a
friend of the crowd for that.
Yeah.
It's the next chapter. It continues the story of Stick of Truth, where you're the new kid, and you now have moved to South Park. But now the kids are playing, obviously, superheroes,
mm-hmm.
and so we get really into your backstory as the new kid of what, like any superhero adventure, like we get into your backstory of why your butthole is so amazing, basically.
Yeah.
Deep into that butthole story.
We're going to get deep into your butthole.
Yeah, deep into your butthole on this one, yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen.
Off to a great start here.
Sweeter, more kind words have never been spoken. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the legends of South Park, Trey Parker, Matt Stone.
Thank you.
Wear those microphones home. I love you.
Bye.
Give it up, Trey and Matt.
Cool.
They should totally make another one of those.
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
I
would
have
never guessed that.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen,
the last one took
this
so long.
Is Ubisoft's E3 2015, that's not a year, 2015 press conference.
Oh,
if it was 2015, we'd have no technology. We'd all be incredibly miserable, staring into our hands, waiting for somebody to tweet us back. I am so insanely happy to be here today. And I don't know about you guys, but I feel like this is a super special time of year because I love games, and I think it's the rare time of year that journalists, developers, gamers, and fans of the industry get to come together in one place and collectively lose our shit. So I am so, so happy to be here. On behalf of the UB team, I want to welcome everybody here to the historic Orpheum Theater in LA, as well as all the gamers, fans, and journalists tuned in online from all over the world. And we have got a very special welcome here for some of our most dedicated fans, Ubisoft star players who are here from around the globe. Please stand and wave. Take your moment in the sun.
What are star players?
You guys look amazing.
Dancers?
Just people
some of you look more amazing than others. I bet the rest of you wish you had more than just a fucking t-shirt, but that's okay. We'll talk about it later. Cosplay it like a boss. Like a boss. All right, sit down. Few industries have consumers as passionate and personally invested as the gaming industry. One day, you're on a message board calling for the abrupt, non-consensual removal of a CEO's reproductive organ on a message board, and the next thing you know, you've got a Far Cry logo tattooed on your face. And let's be honest, I think we all know this has been a very intense year for Ubisoft, and there's been no shortage of, shall we call it, constructive feedback, or online teabagging, whatever you want to call it. But I can say, personally, that after working for these guys for 4 years, the Ubisoft teams listen and they take what you think very, very seriously. We believe here that passionate and honest feedback makes games better, even if you have to dig through ear-burning NSFW, guys, that's a word, Reddit thread to get it. You know what I'm talking about. The UB team has a single
really
driving passion. They love games and they want
to
make kick-ass games that you want to play. And to that end, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the guy with all the surprises, Ubisoft CEO, Yves Guillemot.
Get him out of the way, though.
He's the guy with all the surprises.
Yeah. So many surprises.
Hello, Aichan.
How are you?
How are you?
He's an alien grasshopper under there.
Do the short jokes.
We were in rehearsal. You know how excited I am about this press conference. You guys are going to lose it. This is going to be awesome. Enjoy.
Is he the guy that's transferring himself into Ryan Gosling's
body? I love games.
Yes.
I wasn't sure.
And I love the people that create the games. But I also love a lot the people that play those games. So it's a...
You've never seemed more magical and sprouted from a flower than right now.
At Ubisoft, we do take risks. It has been part of our DNA from day one. And we will continue to take risks to amaze gamers and create the games of tomorrow.
He's so happy.
And today I have a surprise for you, as we said. And this surprise is a new IP in a new genre. And this game couldn't wait till the end of the show. So enjoy it now.
Oh, we're not going to get a ticker or a countdown?
15 minutes to Star Wars Battlefront.
When you look inside yourself to pull off a cane in this situation,
do you see a knight? Viking. Samurai, perhaps, huh?
None of those.
When your enemies are arriving at the gate.
I'm with you, but like
the sword is coming at your head.
He's gonna pull a sword out of that cane.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that had better be a sword cane. Mm-hmm. Oh, would you stand and fight? My name is Jason Vandenberg. Creative director.
I'm not actually having a fucking opportunity.
I know we've done demos like that up on the stage before, but shit, man, come on.
Melee combat, visceral battlefield. Through a new type of gameplay that we call the art of battle, you will feel the weight of the weapon in your hand.
The
crash as you block the attack.
We talked about this.
And the impact.
I know, I'm just saying.
Strike the winning blow. But bring your friends with you. Because while a single individual can win a fight, it takes a band of warriors.
Get that guy! He doesn't even work here! Get him off our stage!
And when I say a band of warriors...
Dude!
I mean two teams!
He pulls out the sword.
Four
if this demo goes bad, he's going to pull the sword cane out.
Multiplayer demonstration on console right now.
Ah, that game is canceled.
I don't even feel it.
This demo is over. He's coming back in full Viking regalia. I am convinced.
Okay. Is that Mountain Blade?
Yeah, I guess.
Oh, weird.
A lot of more people than Mountain Blade, though. Well, maybe not.
Look at all these war men.
Well.
Right, that's all AI, right?
Well, yeah, most of those. I think the ones that don't have names are all AI.
Right. Wait, this is Dynasty Warriors.
Yes.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
would you say?
Ubisoft Dynasty Warriors.
Would it be good Dynasty Warriors, though?
Well, I'm, you know, that's a relative
thing. Looks better than Dynasty Warriors.
Or like Kingdom Under Fire.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking of. Yes.
Except with not
Oh, there's like sword positioning stuff, the Shield Blade style.
All right, yeah, that... There might be something to it. Well, what was the other, what was the actual Ubisoft one with the Wii that came out? That was,
Red Steel?
Yeah, Red Steel.
Red Steel.
Who did 99 Nights?
That was Konami?
Yeah, that sounds about right.
I think, is this the Red Steel guy?
It might be.
Maybe.
Wait, someone, I think someone said it was.
I think it might be the Red Steel guy.
That guy's dead.
Yeah, ripped right from the trailer.
I mean, this seems fine. I'm still just kind of waiting for what the hook is.
Yeah. I think this is the hook. This, like, tactical swordplay stuff.
Yeah, that doesn't come across super well, though.
No. Yeah, it's not really presenting. It's
the kind of thing you need to try to understand.
I feel like kind of trying to present it as a new genre is maybe a little...
Yeah.
I mean, you can see him kind of positioning the sword at the end and stuff.
But there's definitely not been a lot of like super tight like multiplayer melee combat, like tactical combat like that.
Right.
Though, right. I mean,
right.
Yeah.
So that's cool.
Got limping.
Yeah.
Oh, man. It went so differently.
Thank you very much. For honor. Okay. So, that was just a tease of our current build. It's a taste of what For Honor has in store for you. But I know what you're thinking.
Is this a sword game?
Cool, Vandenberg. When can we play it?
Out today.
How about noon tomorrow at the Ubisoft booth with a 100% hands-on 4v4 multiplayer demo on console.
I think you may have framed this poorly.
Yeah. How about we show it at this trade show?
And for those of you watching at home,
too bad.
At forhonorgame.com to get more info and get a chance to be among the very first to play the game. Thank you very much. Have a great evening.
That was
you too,
great.
Buddy.
I think
you too.
I feel like I'm like.
He was better than
Jeff,
the game.
I just bought a car. I think I just bought a car. Awesome.
Guys, give it up for Jason Vandenberg.
Think you own a car now.
For Honor Gaming Team.
Yeah, that was definitely the Red Steel 2.
I just want to say, was super juicy. I really love that last beheading. These next two games are already fan favorites. True. And in response to the feedback from Ubisoft's incredibly engaged communities, the teams have created some incredibly cool expansion packs. Since the crew's release last year, millions of players have spent over 20 million hours free riding all across the United States. That's more than 3,000 times
the distance.
Did you,
like, actually kill me now that we're talking about the crew?
By the way, you cannot drive. The Crew Wild Run expansion pack introduces new larger-than-life vehicles and gives you the chance to compete in ongoing championships.
She's actually talking to you, Jeff.
All over the United States.
Right at you.
Ladies and gentlemen. Start your engine.
It's just an expansion pack. Remain calm.
No! Like, what?
Right?
It's motorcycles.
She said that, right?
Yeah, but...
Finally.
So is this game not that good?
No, it's not that good.
It was bad.
Yeah.
This looks alright.
Alright. It didn't know what it wanted to be, is the thing.
Adding motorcycles and flipping monster trucks is not a way to get it to focus on what it wants to be, but that might still be cool.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Yeah. The crew was this thing with this like big, weird, strange world, and that was the most interesting bit for me. It was like fake billboards.
If this is
weird...
the crew Blood Dragon, then maybe...
Yeah, then maybe.
It's not.
No. Oh, it's weird. It's weird. United States was really weird and fun and cool. But its races were bad.
Available now on the show floor behind closed doors.
Complete graphic overhaul.
Yes. I just get excited. I want to run all over the stage. Now, if you think that was awesome, this next thing is incredible.
I saw this next trailer in rehearsal, and
there are absolutely no words to describe it.
I
so
like
just,
being talked down
just
to.
Check it out.
This is another expansion for the crew.
Oh.
Wait. What?
What the fuck?
Yeah. Is this dark? Wait, no.
Yeah, dark. What the fuck?
It's the boots.
Never mind.
Peggle.
Oh god, alright.
Okay.
No. Yeah?
Hang on.
No.
Go on.
Oh.
What?
What?
Wait.
What?
Right.
Right. Right.
Insane. That was just a tiny taste of the Trials Fusion awesome level max expansion pack.
You're gonna win that unicorn if you're under the clock tower in 2113.
One, PS4 and for the PC. And for any Trials Fusion fan, it's the business. And if you are even a tiny bit still on the fence about this, dude, you're a cat riding a fire-breathing unicorn. What are you, a robot? Now, my friends, we're going to make a hard right turn.
It's kind of not enough, actually.
From kitties and unicorns.
Like, I kind of need to know more about it.
To a virus-ridden urban hellscape.
Finally.
Yes. We have having the same feel at this exact same time. Prepare your bodies for one of Ubi's most highly anticipated games to date. It's time for The Division.
I want to find out what this game is. Show me.
Welcome to the stage, Ryan Barner, game director on The Division. Give it up for Ryan. Bernard. Say your last name right. Bernard.
Hi, how you
Bernard.
Doing, Aisha?
Hi, it's good to see you.
Is my mic working? All right, it's good to see you.
Yes,
good to see
welcome.
All right, hello, everyone. So as probably most of you know from judging from the response out here, The Division is an online open world action RPG. But at its core, it's a cooperative experience. But today, we're here to introduce you to the Dark Zone, a walled-off, quarantined, highly contaminated area all through the middle of Manhattan.
Mm-hmm. We're living in the Dark Zone for the past few hours.
You have the choice whether to work alongside other agents or turn against them. In the Dark Zone, we want you to experience the tension and the fear and the paranoia of playing in a place where absolutely anything can happen at any time.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
A place where you can trust no one.
Hide behind a car,
yeah,
for example.
Like
or jump up on top
exactly,
of it.
Exactly, like Hollywood.
Mm-hmm. Anything,
so
anything can happen.
Here's a glimpse of what could happen to you in the Dark Zone.
I love the Dark Zone!
Oh, they meant Times Square. That's the Dark Zone? Okay.
Hey, man. You ain't wrong.
It's true. I was up there the other day. Oof.
Do not travel alone or unarmed. All right, guys, you ready?
Dark Zone.
Yep.
Are we RPing again? Okay, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
Sweet. Okay, Dark Zone.
Let's do it.
God damn it, we're role-playing this one.
It might not be just us.
In fact, I'm pretty sure I saw a matching screen before this, so it's probably totally not us. Hang on, my kid's crying. I gotta...
It's jammed. Proximity coverage only. Backup activated. System rebooted.
Attention. Risk of infection severely elevated beyond this point. Quarantine is in effect.
We're right behind you. Go ahead.
Okay. Ooh, careful.
I see him.
We got three or four Rikers, looks like level 11, an assault, a sniper, and a rusher.
Shouldn't be too hard.
I see you in your happy place now, man.
There's the crate.
You take the lead, I'll follow.
Yeah, let's do this quickly, okay?
Cool.
Everybody ready?
Yeah, it's
selfies
teamwork.
In the post-apocalypse.
Oh,
that's...
Up behind us. Other players.
Bastards.
They have Dark Zone loot.
Huh. Should we go for it?
I don't know. I mean, we can't take them and the Rikers at the same time.
Good point. Let's just see what they do.
Oh, they're going Rikers.
Right. Let's help them out.
All right, go. I'm gonna flank. Go.
Brian, cover us.
Kind of a Kane and Lynch situation.
Heads up,
like,
heads
are they gonna turn?
We see if
Windows.
I can take him.
Right.
Bronson, use your turret.
Okay, it's up. Turret's up. Get down. I got you. I got you. Go, go, go.
Shit!
Hit him on the left.
It's a data grenade.
I got a seeker mine.
Use it, use it.
Here goes.
Nice, nice. Okay,
last
one.
Yeah, totally.
Proceed with caution.
Alright. Ryan, you want to check out the crate?
Wait, what about those other players?
They're all hanging out now. Everyone's friends, right? Right?
So, right?
Yeah. Nice drop.
Nice. Alright, where to?
Well, let's extract at Bryant Park. That's pretty close.
You can see what the other players
lead the way.
Alright. Looks like these are the guys
you see that they have stuff. You see they have the canisters on their backs now.
Oh.
So you see that they have a thing.
Everybody gets what was in that loop.
Everyone on your team has, they see they all have it.
Let's take them out.
That's too risky. They're all elite. Let's try not to pull aggro.
What are you talking about? There's five of us.
Yeah, five of us with loot that we want to hold on to. Trust me.
God.
Follow me around this way.
Okay.
I would have thought after last year they would have learned to not have fake in-game chat.
Yeah. And just, or at least
like they need to have someone talking. Like what they need to have is someone explaining what the fuck is actually going on here.
Right, yeah. How's it look?
Right. Like what Lindsay's doing is she's
all
going.
Clear. Let's spread out.
They have loot, so they don't want
to
engage.
Keep a lookout,
they need to get to this point so they can extract. They can do this.
Okay, got you covered.
We're all clear. Let's extract.
Okay. We got 90 seconds.
So this is actually like a super frustrating thing because we played this yesterday and can't talk about it until 4 o'clock.
Yeah, we've got another
35
minutes until we can actually talk about
35 minutes until...
We played this exact mission.
I can't help thinking what these guys have.
We recorded a 7.5-minute podcast thing that will go up at 4.
It sounds like this team is saying like, oh, I wonder if we could take that loot from the guys who teamed up with us.
Yeah, yeah. Yes.
Like... Having played this, the chatter makes total perfect sense. Like they are describing how this game works, but I'm sure it sounds ridiculously stilted to people who haven't played it.
I say we do it.
Ryan, you game? Alright, here comes the sticky. On my mark.
Wait, so they just attacked that other?
They turned on the other team.
I'm surprised they framed it this way, which is interesting.
Alright, I got her.
Careful.
I'm running low on health.
I'm a bunch of jerks.
Do you want more shit or less shit?
You need more shit.
So is it?
We're the division.
Is there
Vinny.
Any reason to not do that then? Aside, I guess if you're overpowering
Ryan,
the other team.
Dude, clock's ticking. Let's go. Come on.
Are you leaving?
What the
They just turn.
Yeah. Hostile agent neutralized.
That's interesting.
Cap of the dome.
Like dropping out of your three-man crew to then take it all for yourself.
Wait.
That's what that dude just
yeah,
did.
Yeah, he left the group.
And killed? Wow.
Yeah.
Huh. They didn't mention that you could do that, did they?
Yeah.
Well, that's real feel-good.
I mean, they're doing, like, it seems built to kind of revolve around some of that kind of Kane and Lynch-style stuff of are you going to stick together or not sort of thing.
You know how I feel about this game. I loved it even when the build wasn't finished.
Yes, when you weren't supposed to play.
Yeah, it looks amazing. Huge dick move there at the end. But I want to say, I mean this as a compliment, this game is looking like it needs to come with a giant barrel of Xanax.
Maybe DLC.
When does everybody else get to craft themselves in terror the same way that I did when I played the game last year on the floor?
Well, for those of you lucky enough to be with us here at E3, for the first time, the division is hands-on playable at our booth. So hopefully everyone will come by and play. We're excited about that.
Awesome.
And also for those of you at home who are clamoring to get your hands on the game early, we're happy to announce that we're going to be having betas on Xbox One, PlayStation 4, and PC starting early next year. So everyone will get to play.
It's going to be super exciting. Now,
And please check that out to be able to figure out, get more information about the betas.
Sweet. Now that we know they're moving into beta, when is the game actually going to be available to everybody out there to play, buy, and put into their home box holes?
Yes. Today we're super happy to announce that Tom Clancy's The Division will be released on March 8th, 2016 on all platforms simultaneously.
Yay! Everybody give it up!
So thank you very much, everyone, and have a great E3.
Ryan Bernard, everybody. Let him hear it. I did get to play this game. It's tactical. It's terrifying. It's obviously incredibly cool. So I can't wait for you guys to check it out on the floor. Now, next up this afternoon is the newest release of the critically acclaimed City Builder from Ubisoft's Blue Byte Studio. So everybody, pack up your astronaut diapers because we are departing this planet.
Muff.
Hello? Probably.
That's the thing that Ubisoft puts out. That is.
Sorry, what'd you say?
Anno.
Anno.
That's the city builder. But...
Hey, Mike, what's your ETA?
Heading back now.
Proceed to 26.133 degrees north, 3.628 degrees east.
It's been like 4 years since the last one. This is it.
They buy the rights to Red Faction.
Yo, that'd be pretty good.
They did buy the rights to Red Faction.
I think. Didn't they get it?
Yeah.
Hey, what's up?
Why would you build everything on the dark side?
Because you get those good lights, like...
Yeah, exactly. The lights don't show up well.
Yeah.
I'm in!
What do you do? What happens?
It's a city builder.
Shit.
It's a building trade.
Obviously,
city?
This the moon is awesome.
Not a space thing before? Was
no,
really
they've
like
done
it
throughout history.
You have to
it's like
your lunar 15... landing. So the following gameplay sequence shows how you can make your own giant leap for mankind. And if you want to test out the game, stay tuned for the beta, which starts
gas
later.
Gas mask or a filter?
Yeah. That's Mr. Division.
Okay.
Mr. The Division.
He's dressed as the Division.
I'm going to go tag up a billboard after this.
Is this still Anna?
I think.
Yeah, probably.
They're a little more focused on like trade and industry than SimCity. I've played a couple of them. Yeah.
I thought that I definitely remember seeing it on Steam and it like looked interesting, but I never knew what the heck you'd do in it.
Was this game not announced?
I don't believe so.
Okay. People are talking like it's
space?
Not in all of them, because there are some that are sitting like the
1400s. Oh, okay.
So
you can't get the space.
There's
it's
often
still
like
mission.
A campaign
it's
mode
real hard.
Where it's mission based, where it's like, okay, in this mission you're trying to get up your agriculture and build a city based around this thing or that thing. It's a little bit more.
It's not like Civ, right, where it goes from prehistory to like
no.
the far future.
It's almost always focused on a specific like window of time.
So we've had samurai, we've had fire breathing unicorns, Tally,
oh,
spaceships.
Yeah.
Oh,
this fucking guy.
Who
is that?
Pretty meme-friendly show. What do you think?
Yeah, it's pretty awesome.
You're actually sitting here, and you are your own human life-size meme. Tell me who you are.
Well, I'm Rick from RBF Productions NL, and Ubisoft requested me here as Jacob Fry.
Jacob Fry from AC Syndicate.
Right.
That's look insanely hot. guy from
no
your era probably has rickets or something I can catch, but you look amazing.
I'm a paid cosplayer.
We should come up with a meme really quickly for the show.
Is that,
right now,
that's pretty much what that guy just
Christmas
said, right?
On
yeah.
During so the
they
apocalypse.
Request that
meme.
Yeah.
Just Captain Picard like screaming that out. Do you have a meme you wanna pitch?
I'm a seat filler slash paid
guys
cosplayer.
With rickets are super hot.
Well, if you were talking Picard, it would be Engage.
Okay, good. We did that together. All right. Standing next to me right now.
Right? Not happy. Not happy right now.
The executive producer of our next game,
looking
just as foxy as Jacob.
Punch out of this!
You were rickets. With 110 million players, a billion songs danced, and more than a billion lifetime views on YouTube, this game franchise is one of the pillars of the Ubisoft family. Right? It's time for just
yes.
What? What?
Yeah, sure.
Did you not rehearse this?
Fucking.
they requested that I be here too. Like, leave me alone.
That it is. And because of them, I'm really proud to say that Just Dance has become the biggest music video game franchise of all time.
I gave him his spotlight. So, Now that we're into this, tell me what's happened since last year, because this has been amazing.
We're back with Just Dance 2016 on all motion platforms.
All right, back.
And I got a little bit of news.
On all motion
all
platforms.
You don't need
platforms.
A camera connected to your console to play the
Put
game.
Put it on
anymore.
All
You'll be
emotion
able to use your smartphone
platforms.
As a controller to play Just Dance
Smart
2016.
Phones.
If you okay. have a camera-enabled console.
Didn't we have this already?
You're good.
You're great.
Yeah, they did that
but
last
we know
year.
Many of you uh-huh. don't.
Yeah.
And we're excited to be opening up the game to all console owners, regardless of their setup. And they're going to have a lot to look forward to. An awesome track list, a few chits, new features, and like always, a few surprises. Like this one.
What?
Engage. Oh, wait, turn it back on. Nope.
Oh,
no. No, they can hear it. So they can hear it in the arena. Yes. They just, the beat
okay.
isn't
okay.
coming out.
Okay. All right.
Jason Derulo, right?
Yeah.
Do you think anyone warns dudes like this when they're walking into situations like this? Like, don't worry, the crowd is not going to give a fuck. They're going to sit there and stare at you. Do not try to play to the crowd. Do not try to get them up and dancing. Do not try.
You're about to play to the coldest audience of your entire career.
Do not say, get up and dance with me. Do not engage the audience.
Don't look him in the eye.
Just the professional cosplayers will come up and shimmy near you.
I think he's really singing.
Yeah, it's not clean enough to be able to sing.
Yeah. Good
tweets.
Good.
And Guy Kroll just tweeted Usher.
I miss Usher right now.
Happy Easter, Xbox.
maybe nobody did tell him.
Oh, right next to the cosplayer.
Yeah. Get him up and dance. Oh,
I was like, nah.
Yeah, yeah.
Even nah, Aisha though. Tyler was like, nope.
Learn my lesson.
Yep.
Stick to the script. Just, we'll get the checks and we'll go. And we'll be back next year and be fine.
You know, UB is the last one. The last one that sold.
Like trying to put some theater into
this
shit.
Congratulations, because your album Everything Is For and the single Want to Want Me just hit number one on the top 40 radio charts this morning.
That's what it says on the teleprompter.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
And it was amazing seeing you up there. You know, I had to stay at my seat.
You know what? I'm so glad this song is number one this week and everything, but the only thing is I just wish you came up here and danced with us. You know what I'm saying?
I tried.
I just got to dance.
Sadly, Jason, I am living stumbling proof that not all of our people can dance. That's you know there's got to be one. I missed that meeting. But I want to get into it because I actually heard that you're actually a big fan of Just Dance.
I am. Huge fan. You know,
according
I love
to this
the
teleprompter,
idea that
yes.
music can
see,
was
the contact
like this,
and gave me a
video
bunch of money.
Is, it's such a part
fan.
Of pop culture, and I feel like it allows, you know,
this is
the
a good thing from
like my little niece who loves
Buddy
playing.
Brantley
and
on
you know,
Twitter,
folks,
Ubisoft
like
is the Need for Speed FMV of press conferences.
That's about right.
Yeah.
She can get it, so it inspires everybody. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it's really great. I'm really excited because this obviously this song's a huge
hit. Yeah, good stuff. Good stuff. Anyway.
We're going to want to buy it. We're going to dance. I want to be like
Jason. It has been great.
I want to be like Jason Derulo.
Father of God.
So thank you so much for coming out today. That
Those
was
are
so
also really
exciting.
Weirdly placed pockets.
Those are big surprise. Ladies and gentlemen, I'll see you tomorrow. Give it up for Jason Derulo, everybody.
You don't need to know about that.
You mean cosplay guy.
Jason Derulo.
We are going to fight about that.
We are.
I think she pulled her pocket out.
Just Dance 2016 will be available this October on all platforms.
Boy.
The Wii, Xbox 360,
the
PS3.
Wii.
But we have something special.
The race to the last Xbox Wii game. They just fucking staked their claim.
A lot of Wii's out there.
True.
Oh, okay. Dance streaming service.
Oh, so they'll never have to make another one, right?
Right.
Yeah.
Have to is not really the concern here.
Huh?
We're introducing a streaming service that brings new songs all year long.
You're going to walk out to explain that? That wasn't the end of the segment and you move on? Like, come on!
It's something the fans have been asking for a long time. It's called Just Dance Unlimited, and it's the first ever Dance On Demand streaming subscription service. Anyone with a copy
you
of
didn't
Just
ask
Dance
for
2016
it. We made
Xbox
it.
Warner
Dance
PS4
On Demand.
We'll be able to subscribe.
I demand that you dance!
So great. That's just new, fresh content all the time. So great. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
Everybody give it up for the other Jason, OJ, Jason Allman.
Nobody fixed her goddamn pocket when she went backstage. What the hell is going on?
It was my pleasure.
Holy fuck! Oh,
I cut her off. Thank you so much for doing
I
that bullshit.
I call you here today because we face dire circumstances. Our intelligence has confirmed the existence of a new threat that is unlike any we have seen before.
Great. She looks
this
familiar.
Organization yeah. has the ability to carry out attacks anywhere in the world.
Sam Fisher is back.
They
stop
are highly
the
lethal. And indiscriminate of age, religion, or nationality. The potential for loss of human life and psychological terror is substantial and cannot be ignored. They are the very definition of an unknown quantity. Our only choice of action is to meet force with force. As of this moment, my program is reactivated, and I am handing over command of all global field operations.
Two.
Recruit your operators from among the world's foremost elite. Orders and protocols are irrelevant.
That's international.
We must be the shield that safeguards the civilized world from those who wish to do it harm. No matter how aware our enemies strike, no matter
this
what defense
after
they
her
tower behind, mm-hmm. Team Rainbow must stand ready.
Like Rainbow Six Mercenaries?
Oh.
No.
What?
What?
Wait. What?
That's the setup for yeah.
Siege is just like a hostage situation. Yeah. It's just like, they got a hostage, you got to get in the house and get them.
I personally lost my shit. When I saw Rainbow Six Siege, I was so excited. I love this franchise. Judging from the audience reaction, I think we're all having the same feeling about this game. It is close quarters combat like you have never experienced before.
Nothing about what they've shown in that game seems like it fits into like something that serious.
You stay
I guess
dead.
Maybe that was the thing they were holding
it's
back.
It's explosive, yeah. It's bone-rattling, it's intense, and it's led by an equally intense but cool-headed woman by the name of Six. You probably recognized her
Six.
In the cinematic trailer.
Okay. Six.
And now it is my great
Six.
Honor to welcome
oh, Rainbow
to the stage
Six.
Yeah.
The extraordinary Angela Bassett.
All right.
Angela Bassett. Cool.
Dance. Come on, Angela.
No, Six was the name of the scientist.
Hi,
Six.
How are
Rainbow
you,
Six
gorgeous?
Is a monster.
Oh, my God. All right. I love this game. I love this franchise.
Good.
But now that you're in it, oh my God,
that works out well.
So this is actually the first time that you've been in a video game.
My first time,
right?
Yeah.
So tell me a little bit about that experience for you.
Oh, well, you know, thank you, Aisha. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I play the role of Six, and I'm the deputy director of the Rainbow Six Counterterrorism
Wait.
Unit. It has been a
Rainbow
great
Six.
Experience so far. And, you know, I'm all about playing interesting characters, and this definitely was the venue for that.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think
Hail Shroud.
I'm going to assume that, like, Six is, like, a code name, like, M from James Bond.
You play
the different person is Six each time.
Yours is a little bit more
layered. Plays Blossom and Six gives the orders.
I managed to avoid all that, at least to my knowledge.
Right.
Yeah, well, mostly she just guides the Rainbow Unit, you know, to make sure that the operations has, you know, all of the intel that they need to be able to eliminate threats.
Right. I mean, as an actress, it's incredible to be here with you, because you've played everyone. Tina Turner, Dr. Betty Shabazz, Rosa Parks, now you're Marie Laveau in American Horror Story. Yeah. Were there any ways in which this work differed from those other experiences for you?
Well, I've always gravitated toward characters that, you know, challenge me as an actor. So in that respect, it wasn't very much different. Mm-hmm. And there was a lot of, you know, stuff from a movie set or TV set that was applicable to this. You know, mm-hmm. it's all about character and it's all about story. Okay. You know, and I was able to really just take on the character and make it my own. And of course, you had the director
who
was there leading.
This is like, how much story is in,
you know,
the game?
So after the alpha, they sent out surveys. Sure, this is where I get all my information, apparently. And a big part of the survey was like, well, what part of this game would you like to see more of? And included like more story detail, more about these individual characters.
It's an immersive experience, like
living through a film. And with you in
this film, we get to all play opposite you.
There must be.
I know it's a dream come true for me. I can't wait.
You're going into trouble hiring like a major actress to do this. I assume there is some kind of story going on.
Truly one of the great actresses of our time. Please give it up for Angela Bassett.
It's super cool, but
thank you. Thank you.
So
enjoy
excited.
The game.
It's a story from like what we thought this game was.
Thank you. Give it up for Angela Bassett, everybody.
In the novel, six is the term that refers to the
Okay. Yeah. Okay.
It's canon. All right.
Fucking cool to see Angela Bassett
only been
doing video games.
About multiplayer,
yeah.
But there
awesome.
Is so much more to Siege.
Okay.
And here to tell us more about it, please welcome to the stage Genevieve Forget, the community developer on Rainbow Six Siege.
The Siege God on Twitter.
She's like, that's me.
Oh, it is me. Yay. Thanks, Aisha. Hi, everyone. Ever since we announced at E3 last year, the community has been asking about the solo and co-op experiences
That's a dope
of
name.
Our game.
Genevieve Forget.
Today,
I think it's not pronounced that way.
It is
yes.
now.
That Theront is back.
Put him back in your team, your syndicate team. Yeah. Put her in your syndicate team.
It will be playable solo or with up to four friends. Hmm. In Theront, our players will be facing the most challenging AI in a Rainbow Six game yet. The terrorists will be able to create a stronghold and lead an assault using destruction in unexpected ways. So let's see it in action. Our team's mission will be to disarm bombs set in a French consulate. We'll be following Team Captain Chris Henry over here throughout this demo. Keep in mind that this is a live demo and anything can happen. We hope you enjoy.
Noted.
Chris, are you ready?
Okay. Yes, Jen, thank you.
Team, are you ready?
Yeah, of course.
Yep. Good luck and have fun. Hope
so
you enjoy.
Team chatter.
All right, guys, let's do this.
Yep.
Bruno,
yeah.
I want you to start heading to the right-hand side of your team. Yeah, let's stay back for a second and scout the left-hand side here.
Yeah, okay.
I'm like already confused.
Let me see. There's nothing on the left.
So she said you and four of your friends, so five people total?
It looks like the...
Yeah, that looks
yeah,
right.
Yeah, so the five.
Okay.
I said we stick close
icons
to
on the left side there.
And this was like a pretty popular mode from...
I see an opening of the top floor.
I thought it was from Ghost Recon, not from Rainbow Six, but maybe I'm wrong.
Check them at the east side wall. Let me know if you see anybody inside the window, all right?
At some point, Clancy becomes a blur. Either it's stealth or not stealth.
Yep. Clancy.
Scout it out.
Okay, so we have two guys inside. We could probably take them out quietly.
Okay. Come up to the roof now, Bruno. Yes, clear on my side.
I guess it was in Vegas also.
Okay, I'm gonna need a hand here. Does anybody have a silencer on the other side?
I have a silencer.
How does that work with the
roof? Okay, you want to take him down on go?
Anytime.
3, 2, 1, go.
Got him.
All right, good job, guys.
Nice work. Inside.
Right in.
Take a look at the back of the room. Make sure
I will say a co-op mode for this is exciting.
It's clear.
Exciting.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
Just sit up here for a second, guys.
Yep. Universes AI.
Yeah, something that's like a little more ongoing instead of like the mode they've been showing.
Pretty good behind the first barricade.
Like very bang bang round based type stuff, you know.
There's another barricade on the right here, and I got a lot of nitro cell set up just behind it. I also saw, I saw a bomber here in the middle of the hallway. Nico, can you send your drone out? Start taking care of the drone, the traps.
Yeah, I'll send my shot drone.
Okay, careful. Yeah, bomber's right there. Hold on. So I'm gonna start going back.
Right.
Okay, you're good, man. He's coming back now.
I'm safe?
Yeah, you're good. Okay. Go for it. I'm going to start moving up. Keep an eye on the bomber, all right?
He's coming back. I'll back up.
I have one shield here at the end of the hallway. I got a guy behind the desk.
The bomb there, top of the consulate office desk.
I got one guy also behind the shield. Okay, you guys ready to move up?
Yeah, yes we are. Go.
Gab, Nico, myself, we're going to head down the main hallway. Bruno, Meg, come over here. Tear down the wall, start coming down the left-hand side.
I wonder what percentage of people...
I'll give you some cover.
play games like this with this much communication
right
and teamwork.
Right.
Like for them to show stuff like this,
like it's not as stilted as this. It's a lot more just talking shit and like talking right. like real people. But
this also
like,
seems more natural than what they were trying to present.
Yeah.
Division
yeah. Sure. But you know, like I've played enough like stuff like Destiny. But, you know, like if the game's hard enough and it requires coordination, yeah, right, successful, like, yeah. people will talk their way through.
It doesn't feel like they're role playing here.
Right. No. No. It's more of just necessity. You know. It's just like if we don't work together properly.
Right. Right.
Mm-hmm. Right, okay. Right, like, right there, he definitely needed to say, don't run forward or else my grenade launcher
right.
Yeah.
He's right there.
The whole, like, play your class cliche, right?
We're okay.
Yeah, yeah. Like, hey, don't fuck this up, because it'll ruin it for everybody.
Nice work, okay. Thanks. You're heard, amen.
I feel like I've had short bursts of
the hallway's pretty open, so take cover behind my shield here.
Oh, this worked out really well, we coordinated, and then it's all done.
You guys can start moving up on the left-hand side. Yeah, take your time. There's a couple of guys on the end here. There's a lot of them. Three guys. Four. Okay, left shot. I'm reloading. Left shot.
Back down.
I got him.
Bruno, picking him.
Yep. Push forward. There's one guy in the console office. Got one down, two down.
Just move towards the sort of like... team-based, okay, almost puzzle action design stuff. Feels like a really interesting runoff of the like MMO craze of the 2000s, where like raid design has slowly moved into smaller co-op stuff.
But also it's something that like is a little more accessible because you have so many people that are just not going to be dedicated enough to play a competitive game.
Right? I mean, even something like that co-op mode in Syndicate seems to have traces of that sort of thing.
Sure.
They point in the front door and check the hallway there.
It's very nascent there, though, in terms of, like, teamwork and stuff you need to do, like...
Hack that guy, please.
Right, yeah. Hey, could you hack that grenade? Oh, you already did.
Yeah.
I'm gonna drop the diffuser right behind you.
Yeah, I gotta go.
I played a bunch of that, we got this. Mass Effect multiplayer. Yeah, like that had, like, a very, like, you couldn't survive on your own very long.
You have to watch each other's backs. I think it ends up being, like, part of the reason I shy away from games like this is, like, not wanting to rely on other people and not necessarily wanting other people to rely on me. You know, like, I don't want to fuck anything up for other people, and I don't want to be in a situation where some jack-off is messing up my stuff either, you know?
It's the kind of situation that Dota takes to the extreme.
Like,
everybody's on point, and it really works. It's better than anything ever, but it's so easy for it to completely fry shit, and then you feel awful.
That's all the reasons I'm not a mobile guy.
Yeah.
There's two guys back there.
Double.
Not moving. Okay, check it back up. I got it. It's coming in the back windows. Back windows. They're in now.
The windows covered. It's okay.
Okay.
I got you, Nico.
Alright, hold up. I got the hallway.
Take it, guys. Keep it up. Windows again. Appointment. Back there.
See that guy. Don't move.
Back there. Appointment back there. Yeah.
Right,
yeah.
Keep it up.
Down. I'm down. Nice work, guys.
We got this.
Start heading to the other bomb. Nice
good
work.
Job. Yeah.
Down.
Hey, did they win?
They defused the bomb.
Yeah. We all won. Counter-terrorist one.
Well done, guys. You did it this time, huh? All right. Thank you very much for this. What you just saw was one out of our 4 Terror Hunt modes that we'll have in Rainbow Six Siege, including Terror Hunt Classic. For those of you who are here in LA, we invite you to come to our booth to get a first hands-on experience of Terror Hunt, as well as try our new PvP mode and map. And for everybody else back at home, we got something for you as well. We are glad to announce that our beta starts on September 24th.
That's a very distant, we have something for you.
Yeah, I was going to say, like, someone didn't get the memo that
it will be available
the trend is
on
do it now!
Platforms, and you'll be able to play both PvP and Terror Hunt. Thank you, everyone, so much, and have a great show.
Genevieve Forger! Give it up for her and the Rainbow Six Siege team for that live demo.
That's how you say
that? Forger.
Forger?
But I'm going to call
it. I actually watched those guys play that in rehearsal and they lost, so just so you know, that's real gameplay. That's the first time I've seen them win. I was like, oh, I kind of want them to lose again. I first fell in love with gaming, I think like most old people like me did, loitering around in arcades. As a kid, my two best friends were named Defender and Tempest. I occasionally kicked it with Qbert. These were beautiful friendships based on a solid foundation of quarters. And while arcades are mostly gone now, that style of gameplay is alive and well, as evidenced by Trackmania.
Now you believe it.
This year, Trackmania is finally making the leap from PC to new-gen consoles, and it's bringing its thriving community of customizable maps along with it. Take a look.
New-gen? That's how it's pronounced.
Pretty much.
All these cars are okay, kind of.
They're
not transparent enough. These
guys are really mishandling this curve system. It's pretty.
Whoa.
Yeah.
I wonder if I'll add collision things with, like, other cars.
Yep. That's what that...
That guy looked like he hit the environment.
Yeah. Collision would destroy this entire game.
Yeah.
Why is that? There's too many cars in the track?
They're like, it's all like time travel stuff, right? Like you just...
Yeah, yeah.
Everybody, please give it up for Tommy Francois and Francois Allo.
Man, Questmania looks weird.
Yeah.
Never could have guessed.
Hello, everyone.
Bonjour.
That trailer was cut from gameplay footage and track replay. What you see is what you get.
Good.
Now let's put our money where our mouth is and show you the game. Francois, make yourself at home.
It's a weird VR helmet.
Francois, after you.
That's 117. The other cars you see on screen are ghosts of the best time.
Okay.
Now play.
Like now play. Solo, like single player Trackmania is like not at all interesting. Like
this doesn't look like what you just showed me.
Redone UI, okay.
A UI.
But yeah, I mean, well, whatever. The UI in Trackmania is just like whatever mod you're running.
Right.
It's just fucking gibberish all over the screen.
Yeah.
I'm done. That's enough for me.
All right. Let's go to track.
Freaking out of there.
It's pretty impressive. 10 more tracks in Stadium just for the Blue Series. 4 environments, 4 different gameplays, 5 difficulty levels. A total of 200 tracks. And if you think that's not enough, take a look at this magic. Our track builder mode generates levels on the fly at the press of one button. It's random, so we have no idea what we're going to drive. 3 steps to it. Terraforming.
Okay.
Look at the pretty beaches and islands. Then the track being built. And finally, signage. Infinite tracks you can immediately play. Let's see how well you do, Francois. And be careful, it's tricky.
Back for GPS.
Well, I mean,
Track Mania.
Win an Academy Award than playing Live 83,
yeah.
Man.
Yeah,
funny. I wouldn't believe it if he didn't wreck.
Immediate.
Go.
Yeah.
Now we'll do it perfectly.
Cool.
Jesus.
Keep it going.
That's bad.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
By the way, this is a completely new environment, especially made for Trackmania Turbo. It's called Roller Coaster Lagoon. We also have a brand new take on multiplayer modes, but for that,
come
beat times on the arcade machines on the booth. And if you're crazy enough, come play the VR demo at the show. Thank you.
Arigato deimasu.
Dankeschön.
Cheche.
Gracias.
Merci.
Spasiba.
It's good that the Trackmania demo was done by fucking lunatics.
Yep.
All right, give it up for Tommy and Francois. Clearly multilingual. Our next game has it all. A globe, yes, I understand.
Yeah, and the multiplayer is the side of that that you care about.
A global conspiracy, multiple covert murders, and leaps from unreasonable heights with absolutely no physical repercussion whatsoever. Shine up your blades and lace up your greaves. This is Assassin's Creed Syndicate.
We'll zoom out, just that dude from that game before with the cave.
Isn't this one largely coming out of a different studio than Montreal for once? Isn't that one of the things about this?
I'm not sure.
Oh, I think he got the message.
I feel like the spotty nature of the last few of these have made it really hard for me to even look at this thing.
Yeah, totally. That's why I was wondering about who's making it.
The fun never stops. Come on, look lively, Rooks!
It was really just Unity, right?
Three in Unity. I mean, two of the last three of those games in the main line have been bad.
White Flag was solid, but... Freaking half a hood.
Yeah.
Now you're doing more business.
Like the way they cast off the real world story stuff. In such a haphazard way, you know, it's...
I just wish they'd freed themselves from that stuff entirely.
As soon as it just became like, now it is just 100% a way for us to simulate different time periods and kind of have this loose story thing with nothing tying it together, like, it has no weight for me anymore.
Yeah, but
I know a lot of people don't care about any of that stuff, and that's fine, but I just...
For me, it's more like the giving the ramshackle way that they wrapped up the modern day story stuff.
Yeah.
Like maybe they're better off not trying it because that stuff sounded terrible.
Well, it came off as like they just wanted to punch out of it the quickest way possible.
The Black Flag stuff of like, hey, you're an Abstergo employee. Like that stuff kind of had promise.
Felt like them trying to free themselves of that stuff as much as they could.
Yeah. But it seemed like that was just there out of obligation reference that this is still that, you know?
The thing is, like, with those first three games, a lot of, or the first three, the first, whatever, through the Desmond cycle or whatever, a lot of, like, the kind of narrative shortcomings of the back-in-time stuff was papered over by the fact that, oh, it's going to all connect.
Right.
It's going to mean something.
Yeah.
And,
Was the Animus stuff done after 3? Is that the last one that really went heavy with
that? Well, Black Flag had it, but it was kind of perfunctory because...
Yeah, it's more like you are...
I'll let you take it from
like
here, lads.
Doing research for a video game console that is a consumer version of the Animus.
Okay.
Like, I never thought either of those stories was fantastic, but like together, it was like, okay, there's something...
Right, there is potential to that. Every time out, you think like, oh, there could be something really cool here.
Draw the bitter.
Who's it?
It's actually quite drinkable. Go on, toast your noble boss, this thief of children. Or you could do better, join me. Join the Rooks.
It's trailers. Sorry.
Yeah, there's just like a lot of everything happening.
Okay. Really weird Assassin's Creed trailer. Unless they just completely got away from assassinating anyone.
It's a rough and tumble time. Didn't need stealth.
It's true.
Jacob! Mr. Fry! Listen! We can split the money. I mean, just take it all.
Requiem and Pache, fucker.
Rooks!
With me.
Going with a rook. Come on, I'll see it enough.
So this is like more recruit assassins?
I don't know. It'd be nice if they got back to some amount of like brotherhood type stuff.
That's what I think it's like you're
if I could snap my fingers and like break fools' necks or have people dive out. You know, that was always cool.
Mm-hmm.
Hello,
I guess like Brotherhood seems like that's the best that this series has ever been.
My name is Sakedi Sikoti, and I'm the creative director on Assassin's Creed Syndicate.
Quebec.
Our game takes place in London in 1868, right in the middle of the Industrial Revolution. This pivotal moment in humanity's history has allowed us to create the first modern Assassin's Creed game. Together with their street gang, our two assassins, the twins Jacob and Evie Fry, will fight to take London out of the hands of the greedy and the corrupt in order to give the city back to its people. We have a brand new gameplay demo to show you at the Ubisoft booth. But this year, we are letting you play the game here at E3 and on console. If you're not one of the lucky few to be able to make it to the Ubisoft booth, well, we're excited to give our fans the chance to play the game at the Uplay Lounge here in LA, and get this, in 7 cities across Europe and Australia.
Just release it, man.
So, cool.
Put the demo of it out there.
Yeah.
Throw it out there.
And they have to assert it.
If you want to start playing Assassin's Creed Syndicate starting tomorrow, just sign up at AssassinsCreed.com for your chance to take back London. Thank you, and have a great E3.
Oh, you're kidding.
No gameplay demo.
Explain to me what the hell the game is.
Yeah.
Nice.
Woof.
That's right, it's the people who made the Freedom Cry DLC.
That, my friends,
are making this
was awesome. Incredible PC in that game that you guys are going to be able to experience out on the floor and around the world. And I think that's pretty much it.
Is it?
Except for this one last thing. Everybody put them together one more time for Ubisoft CEO, Yves Guillemot.
What's this one, huh?
Rocksmith. He's going to put a guitar on and just fucking rip for like 45 minutes.
I've been playing Rocksmith. I learned how to shred. Check this out.
We really like to surprise you with revolutionizing our beloved franchises.
If you want to see this surprise, come to the booth.
And
for those at home,
has been done by a group
if you're in Australia,
Paris,
you can play.
A very good group that is working in secrecy, and he has been able to create some things that I'm sure you will enjoy because it is so good. So have a look.
Most of us fear death, but for the Santa Blanca drug cartel, death is a saint. They embrace her, praise her, worship her. They kill thousands without repercussions. Trafficking poison across South America.
This is the other Trials Fusion DLC.
Corroding governments. How do you fight an enemy that doesn't fear death? Maybe you hunt them from the clouds.
Maybe you use your smartphone to change the traffic lights.
Hunt them from the cloud.
What is this?
Drop zone?
Get down with the victim.
Oh god, not this fucking song again.
It's not even a Far Cry, right? It's like,
yes,
would you play a Far Cry?
I don't think it's a new Far Cry.
It doesn't look like Far Cry. This is not all.
It's like a third person.
In position.
Rainbow Six Far Cry.
They're loading up the cocaine.
Why is that so funny?
White hat.
You can't fight description!
What?
Cocaine is on the move. Cocaine is on the move. Targets are falling out.
Get the cocaine.
Move that dope.
Target down. Awesome.
It's like some kind of smuggler's run.
Or you fight from the shadow.
Or the opposite.
Yeah.
Attack when they least expect.
There's that cocaine.
Like start all that before it gets all. Oh, see, you can't. That's just a waste.
It's unsanitary now. You just don't.
Tom Clancy's blood. Oh,
that was a cool transition.
Yeah,
we at Ubisoft mixed a lot of blood with a lot of cocaine to ensure maximum accuracy.
First person. Brief.
What time of day you want to go?
I got White Hat.
Didn't they already kill White Hat.
This is their show option. Yeah.
No, this is like the stealth mode.
Alright, now you turn rogue and keep it all for yourself.
Yeah, is this just a video game Marco Corrido or something?
Yeah, Sleepy Dogs.
JBL. Stealth.
Yeah, stealth. Yeah.
Or you can unleash chaos.
It says this is a Ghost Recon.
Strike from every side.
What?
Confuse them. Destroy everything. Decide who lives and who dies.
From third person to aim down sights is kind of jarring.
Yeah, that's always a little...
Yeah.
...much.
Cocaine again.
Second white hat.
Just leave alive, just the cocaine got taken.
Yeah.
It'll take care of itself.
Yep.
Finally! That fucking song off.
Those middle school kids went home, right? They're not here anymore, right?
Now here's the hug and kissing option.
Ghost Recon Wildlands? That's what we say, man.
Sure.
That's
what Twitter said. Sure.
Set a release on time.
How do you fight an enemy that doesn't fear death? You manipulate them from the inside. Until the monsters wipe each other out.
Mercenaries?
Like, kinda, right?
It seems like that's at least inspiration.
Not great.
Not enough airstrikes for that, though.
Yeah.
Or Han Solo.
Play as a samurai.
Or Clark Dax.
Or a motorcycle.
Pretty sure the cocaine's on the top of this tower. We gotta climb this tower and get the cocaine.
The truck is just parked up there.
Yeah.
This game is actually just clear and present danger, isn't it?
What's our next target? The world.
Oh. Come on!
You were so close!
Yeah. Mother!
Oh. Like the cocaine bombs.
Whoa.
That was the whole earth.
Cool. This is the kind of insane, immersive, cinematic, open-world gameplay that you come to Ubisoft for.
Yeah,
I know
cool.
You felt that all
like
in your bones.
In the world.
Ladies
Collector's
gentlemen,
Edition
that is
comes
show.
With an 8 ball.
Thank you so much for coming out today. Thanks to everybody watching at home. Stay tuned for the live post show. We're going to chat with all of today's
Walk
speakers.
And talk.
If you're in Los Angeles, check out our booth and the Uplay Lounge to see Ghost Recon in action. And if you're not in LA, check out Ubisoft.com for exclusive E3 insider access. Be sure to join our social media conversation by using the hashtag UBE3. We want to hear from you, and we mean it, no matter how painful or crappy your tweet. My name is Aisha Tyler. This is Ubisoft. Play on!
Remember when this happened? At the end
I
of
do.
A WrestleMania. Remember when these people stood up?
Oh, more.
Huh. Well,
Ubisoft.
That was fun.
Well, certainly more lively than the last one.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's
that Ghost
Recon
cool
looks
stuff
cool.
There,
yeah.
So I haven't played Ghost Recon in a while. Is that Ghost Recon hasn't had a game in between, like, hey, you guys are, like, military and,
Future
like...
Future Soldier was the last
right,
one.
Right, and that was no good.
Yeah, yeah.
So what does Ghost Recon mean at this point?
Gras 2.
Yeah, there was Advanced Warfighter. Before that, it was, you know, kind of just a Rainbow Six offshoot.
Right.
You know, but that's... I mean, you'll note that they didn't even say Tom Clancy anywhere on that thing.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I did not see that.
So, at some point, like, maybe they're just, like, breaking that out and going, like, hey, you know, weird open world coke game.
Yeah.
You know, like Ghost Recon will say the kind of military thing that we want it to say, but it doesn't necessarily need to fit into Tom Clancy. It doesn't need to be part of that whole thing. So
it's like some straight up Deck of 52 stuff there at the end.
Yeah.
Yeah, a little bit. I wonder like what the faction like who are you working for in this? Like what is your role in the overall story if you're military?
Or, seems like it. I mean, you know, the refrain was like, kept going back to, how do you take these guys down?
Right, but why are you taking them down? I mean, every single one ended with, we've got the cocaine! So, you know, is that cocaine getting turned into the U.S. government? Or are you just, like, running your own operation?
Well,
like,
that's the
story-wise, like, what is...
To the narrative they were painting here was, like, get the cocaine so that guy... So they turn on each other,
exactly,
right?
Exactly,
so,
yeah,
I don't know, maybe
yeah.
they're doing some black ops.
Yeah, it does seem like I'm in some kind of shadowy sort of thing.
A lot of blood. What was the other one? For Honor?
For Honor.
For Honor.
Yeah.
I'd be curious
like
to see
more
of that,
too. 4 plus AIs.
Yeah.
That's like the Viking one, right?
Samurai. Yeah, yeah, so that was that had the time travel stuff. That was supposed to be the hook for what Patrice's game was, right? So is it right? So
I think that's right.
So is that Patrice's game?
I don't. Which one?
For Honor.
I don't think so.
No, I don't think that's Patrice's game.
I doubt it.
Or the game that was the game formerly known as Patrice's game?
I don't think so.
Okay.
I mean, that looks like if that's the Red Steel 2 guy, then that's
people are saying
he did both. He did both Red Steel games, actually.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, because it wasn't time travel, but it was different settings.
Right.
You know?
Yes.
So,
and like it did look like samurai fighting Vikings in some
yeah.
of those shots.
Yeah,
like,
it did seem like time travel, more of a mishmash.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a little weird, but
Siege with a big narrative.
Yeah, big story for Siege.
Angel
which is, totally unexpected. I thought that game was just going to be like bone dry. Like here's this. Mode. And
we're still not 100% sure if it has a big story mode because what they showed was a co-op, like. Mission, the Terra Hunt mode, which people reminded me have been in old Rainbow Six games
from
a while ago. And that could just be like a framing device. Who knows? It's going to be weird to see what
or
that
could
is.
Be a trailer device.
Right, exactly. We brought in Angela Bassett for our trailer.
Into the game, yeah.
Yeah.
Stick of Truth? Or not Stick of Truth.
Fractured Butthole.
Thank you. Yeah. Right.
Thank you for not spacing that out.
The title reveal was amazing.
Yeah. I don't really think anybody
so not Obsidian.
Not Obsidian.
Yeah.
Ubisoft San Francisco?
I would hazard to guess that given how long that first game took, they just said, you know what, we're going to take it from here.
But that's, I mean, how much of that is on Obsidian and how much of that is on, like, THQ and all this other stuff?
Right.
Like, you know,
I think a lot of it
the winding road for that first South Park game, you could point a lot of fingers and a lot
that's
of
the thing.
Right?
I'm not saying it's their fault. I'm just saying maybe Ubisoft... felt it would
maybe.
Be better
how
just
much,
to bring
how
it
how much
in
of
house.
That is on Parker and Stone?
I think a ton of it was on Parker and Stone from what I've heard.
I've heard similar things.
Because they're so used to being able to scrap something from the show and they can just rebuild it in like a day, but like that's not how it works.
The way they work the people in their studio 100 hours a week, totally believe that.
But
date at all on that thing.
Yeah.
Like that year.
Right.
So. Well,
yeah.
you know, like that, in that case, like it depends on them writing the material, you know?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
For that's the bottleneck, right?
Yeah. And I mean, people loved that first game. So
it's good.
Yeah,
it's a really good game.
So much better than any right to be.
That Assassin's Creed thing seemed like super underwhelming.
It was a mess.
Like, a real mess. And
man, no demo of that game.
No even description.
I mean, they're
like
saying it's hands on, right? They said
yeah,
come to the show
which
and play
is fine.
It. But also, it's at 4:00. We played The Division. It was 3-on-3-on-3.
Yeah.
A 9-player thing is what we were playing. Yeah. They refused to answer any questions about the size and scope of the game.
Yeah.
It was more just like, hey, here's this thing. So it started out as kind of a, and there's a podcast up on the site now with us kind of going over the same stuff, but it started out with us going into this dark zone, finding this loot, and then everyone's got the loot and everyone has to extract. So you're all headed for the three teams are all kind of headed for the same extraction zone. You can keep it peaceful, all extract, but you'll find more loot or you'll get more loot if you're gunned down the other team, take their loot, and then try to get a helicopter. So basically, you get into the extraction zone, hold down X, fire a shot, and then the helicopter shows up in 90 seconds. Unless the person who called in the helicopter dies, then it gets canceled.
Oh.
So you have to keep that person alive long enough for the helicopter to show up. You drop your box, your loot gets extracted, and then those items are yours when the match is over.
Were there NPCs, like enemy NPCs?
Yeah.
The way? Okay.
Yeah, you had to fight AI to get the loot.
I gotcha.
Do you have to fight AI to extract?
No.
Is there any?
There is some AI in the extraction process. There are a few of the guys here and there.
So is there any benefit to working together at the extraction time?
Just to stay alive and get, like, you'll guarantee what you got and what they got.
Okay.
But if you want what they got and what you got,
and
then you have to roll the dice.
AI
you
know, from
you,
maybe
yeah,
killing you.
But they might take your shit and get out.
Okay.
You know? So there's sort of a...
Can you, like, just let the AI try and pick them off and hide and then just loot?
Or, you know, because there were three teams of three, you could hang back, let the other two teams do their thing, But they respawn. It's not a regular, you know, if you go rogue, the respawn timer is longer, but there are respawns in it. So they're kind of going to keep coming at you.
Oh, weird.
That did not, that did not
look at permadeath at all.
It's not. Okay. Not at all permadeath.
So like when you get into a match, you guys might not know this, I don't know if they talked about it. Is it basically like you, the three of us, and then we like matchmake and like...
So the way they positioned it with that like kind of role-playing that those people were doing in this demo, it almost made it sound like they were roaming around doing other stuff, and then they just decided to go into the Dark Zone.
And so like that's the multiplayer.
I wonder if that's something where like you just walk into the past the border and it throws you into matchmaking just by entering that area.
Entered the Dark Zone.
And they said they have Dark Zone gear or something.
Yeah,
like
well, it's contaminated.
So that's their how they keep you from just finding the loot and immediately equipping it is it's contaminated. So you put it in your Dark Zone bag and you have to extract it, clean it, and then you can use it and equip it and all this other stuff. They didn't let us equip anything.
Yeah.
They had preset characters and stuff, but it was like, you know, different weapon types with like damage numbers on them. And
So it's a loot.
It's
a
loot.
Destiny.
The controller thing had like references to loot on it. Okay. Like they straight up use the word loot.
Yeah.
And it's color coded. It's like green, blue, purple stuff.
Hmm. Yeah. So like we got a light machine gun, I think, when we played and everyone would have gotten it if we had extracted successfully.
We don't know if that's like an open world thing or if that's instanced matches
right.
or if that's...
Every question we asked about like, is this the total number of players it supports? Like blah blah blah. It was always like yes. In this demo, that's yes. Like they wouldn't say anything about the larger game.
So it seems like it has potential. Like I thought it felt all right, but still kind of confused about the scope of the game overall. Yeah. You know, like how you're going to get into that, how you're going to get out of it. And like what does it look like when you're not in the middle of the shit?
Like what else exists outside of that mode?
Yeah. Like after you guys extracted, it was just demo over?
Yeah.
Okay, so it's not like it booted you back to some base or anything?
No.
So Ubisoft actually did put up a 4-minute gameplay demo of Assassin's Creed Syndicate on their YouTube channel. Of like you tracking a target like across like a moving train and some other shit going on. Right. So
I'll have to check that out.
I don't know why they wouldn't have put that in their press conference, but there is something out there.
Jason Derulo had to perform. Yeah. So. Right. I mean, Just Dance is huge. It's like a huge franchise. Like of course they would spend time with it. It's a massive thing still probably. And you know, lowering the barrier further and further. Like I was always more into Dance Central because it seemed like more like actual dancing as opposed to like holding the Wii remote in a dancey way. Just always seemed like a cop-out, but...
Especially with the phones one, is that just like put the phone in your pocket?
Or same deal. It's just, you know, phone dance. Huh. But not like bounden. Not cool. Not cool phone dance.
Okay. How you feeling about that Trackmania business?
It's, I need to see the multiplayer and what they're doing in terms of, like, the size of that thing. Like, if it's a situation, like, Trackmania multiplayer works because people run their own servers and it's fucking nonsense. You know, everyone picks the tracks they want to run, the style of tracks they want to run, the type of music they want to play, all that sort of stuff to me is totally wrapped up in that experience. And if you remove that and just say like, well, we got our block-based track editor, you can make all your tracks, but it's just going to be this type of music, this HUD, this and this and that, you know, like that's way less interesting.
They said that was a random track editor, right?
Yeah. It seemed like instead of just like going in and building your track, you could just hit go and...
Articulate the splines.
generate a track and drive it.
That's kind of interesting.
Yeah, it's neat. That is neat.
So the Assassin's Creed stuff, was it known that there are like twins or there are two characters in it? Like,
that's been announced.
Yeah,
they
talked about that.
So is there like a co-op aspect to it?
I think you just play one or the
other. Yeah, you just pick one of the characters and the story is told.
My eyes glazed over at some point in that, and what you're saying about there being twins, I'm like, no, dude, that's the Old Republic expansion.
No, those are different twins.
They've done a real bad job of reminding people that there is a playable female character in the game.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right, yeah, they did say that, didn't they?
Yeah, I didn't catch that until they had the very
no
end.
Part of Assassin's Creed.
Like, she's not even in this trailer. Like, but yeah.
I mean, it looks like cool setting.
Again, one of those great surveys was like, what has you most excited about Assassin's Creed Syndicate? There were a bunch of options. One of them was like Jacob Fry, the first assassin of the modern era, and another one was Evie Fry, Jacob Fry's sister.
Yeah,
I was like, all right, guys,
the second assassin.
The series
is just starting to feel dated. There are other games doing better, like, every major aspect of what those games do at this point, you know, like the open world urban stuff, like parkour, like
climbing towers.
Yeah.
Even within their own company. Like, even Ubisoft is doing it better. It did seem like you had a grappling hook. Is that also?
That's a thing. Yeah, that, okay.
I don't know. It's too bad. I wish I could be more excited about an Assassin's Creed game, but they've been, like I said, two of the last three have been pretty bad games.
But also, just the way they presented it here almost felt like a tacit acknowledgement on their part of, like, yeah, we have to keep making these because they sell gangbusters. We're just going to go through the motions. Here's the new trailer. Go play it if you want to.
Well, more and more, for me, it seems like they have just departed so far off from the original vision of what that series was.
Yeah.
Like, the original kind of, like, assassinate somebody, and, like, you're this, you know, like, guild of,
here's,
like,
this Clockwork City, like, figure out the way you're going to take this challenge on. Like, that's
really
it hasn't
a different
really
game.
Been that for a while, no, I think.
Like two or three
except
games.
In little bits and pieces, but, yeah. Yeah, that doesn't...
Just no eavesdropping. Just that's all.
Right. Yeah. Simple stuff. No escort missions. No eavesdropping. Kind of. Just don't make me follow people.
What else do they have? It was a long show.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Right.
What is the multiplayer sword Viking upsetting bearded man game? Yeah.
That's for honor.
Yeah.
We talked about that.
Did.
Yeah.
I'll play that. I guess.
You're a big Mountain Blade fan.
I'm a big Mountain Blade fan. I've dumped a lot of time into Mountain Blade, and especially there is a Mountain Blade 1 mod called Star Wars Conquest, which brought over Star Wars like stuff, but like, didn't change any of the physics of that game. So like the lasers still fire like arrows do, and that's all I want really. It's just more janky ass.
Yeah, laser arrows.
But yeah, so yeah, I'd play that, and I'm also sort of a Dynasty Warriors guy and a Bushido Blade guy.
I mean, you know, nothing wrong with Bushido Blade. Like that's actually, watching some of that one-on-one combat there towards the end of the time, and I'm like, okay. Yeah,
it also reminded me of that Kickstarter by the guy who wrote Snow Crash.
Right. Neil Stevenson.
Right.
Yeah,
who was doing that one-on-one tactical sword game.
Yeah,
that's right.
Clang. Yeah, that thing failed spectacularly.
Really?
It cleared Kickstarter, and then
they never delivered.
Moved away from it.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, they delivered a prototype, like, internally, and that technically...
Like,
was what the Kickstarter was for. Yeah. So, but yeah, so I'm up for like weird tactical sword fighting in big mass combat stuff. Sure.
Yeah.
Why not?
But yeah, I don't know. I have hopes for the Division. You know, like that seems like something that has real potential, depending on kind of how deep it goes, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
I wonder if there's any single player to that. Like if you're not going into the dark zone, or whatever. If you just kind of run around and
do your own thing. Yeah. Yeah, it's hard to say.
Yeah.
And I thought that Ghost Recon looked really cool.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, all their stuff is... I don't think they really have... I mean, aside from... Yeah, I'm trying to think any single-player stuff to show. I mean, Siege was basically multiplayer.
Yeah. I mean, Anno was a big single-player.
Anno will be single-player.
You know, Trials Fusion expansion. Hey, that Crew DLC.
You're right. I forgot that.
Sure does exist.
Monster trucks. You're not wrong.
It looked all right. Right?
You know
what?
The crew looked all right.
Mm-hmm.
There were parts of the crew that, like, thematically you're like, okay,
yeah.
But the execution on the crew was so fouled up that it was just... Yeah.
And, like, the thing that's scary is it was fouled up in the way that a lot of these Ubisoft games are going. It was towers, it was weird progression systems in a game that, like, they just never hooked you in the way. And, like... Yeah. If they don't figure that shit out, then the Division is going to look bad.
And they were
too.
Running practically unopposed for that type of like loose arcade driving game last year. You know, like there was no Need for Speed, like there was nothing else.
Forza Horizon around then, or
I guess
But even that was not
Forza
as
Horizon
loose.
Seems like it's it's still a Forza game under the hood, right? Yeah. It's just you know, their fun version. The crew, man, it should have been better.
Yeah.
Yep. So maybe the DLC does that, but I don't know.
We'll see.
Man. Like, that just seems, like, super tainted.
It seems so focused on, like, monster trucks and, like, the BMX bikes and stuff. Yeah. And, like, maybe it's more of a, like, stunty kind of rally thing and not this big, like, story across
maybe
the
they
country
just custom,
or whatever.
What if they customized the entire country just to be, like, one big dirt track?
Okay. The thing is, like, that stuff in the crew was not very good. Like, it tried to have those big explosive moments with, like, big different size cars, and like that stuff just never hit. It
like
never
all
felt.
The raid truck stuff where you're just like, run this car off the road. It's like, this sucks.
This sucks.
This is fucking terrible. Like Smuggler's Run.
Yeah.
bad.
So maybe they fixed it. Maybe they improved that stuff. There is stuff about the crew that I have like a warm spot in my heart for, but it's going to take a lot of work for it to be good.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well.
Well, yeah.
Yeah, so I don't know. Between this one and EA, I feel like
there was like, does that sound mean? I feel like there was like one press conference's worth of good stuff between those two.
It's just a lot of like,
but that's, you know, that's how it goes. It's kind of always that way to some extent.
I think I really feel like I wish I'd seen some more Assassin's Creed stuff.
Yeah, I feel like Ubisoft had games that they didn't necessarily show appropriately, and EA was like,
EA was just weird.
They'd spent too much time on the wrong stuff.
Maybe Ubisoft was kind of
the same problem in some cases. Like, right? They're just like, here's a trailer of Assassin's Creed, but not the actual game. Yeah. Here's, you know, this, you know, here's Jason Derulo reminding you that Just Dance exists, and you know, like that sort of stuff. Like, Jason Derulo is Ubisoft's Pele. Is that
okay?
Jason Derulo didn't quite put me to sleep the way Pele did, but
I don't know.
Pele used to be Ubisoft's Pele.
It's true.
A few years ago.
That's true.
Accurate.
Well, the other thing is, like, they just got completely away from, let me talk to you about what this game is. They went all the way to, like, endemic, like, people playing the game and talking about, just playing the game and talking through what they're doing, and that wasn't, I need a little bit of narration to help
sell
me
for something
game.
Like The Division that they have been really bad at, you know, kind of conveying to people. Like, that seems like a key thing that they fucked up. Yeah. It's still not immediately clear from their presentations what it is. Whatever. I mean, we played that thing, and I'm still not 100% clear on what that game is.
Well, they're just not saying.
Yeah.
Maybe they don't know yet. Maybe it's not. Maybe a lot of stuff is up in the air still.
Figure that out. For a game that's due out in March, that'd be real scary.
That Siege gameplay they showed, it didn't look that great to me for some reason.
Cool.
I don't know. Something about, like, I think I was thinking more frenetic and fast-paced, like, once the action started. It just kind of looked like a corridor shooter.
Kind of compared to the multiplayer mode they've been showing, that kind of is the fast and frenetic.
Okay.
So it's definitely faster than kind of like the, all right, here's our planning phase, let's go do this, here's this, let's go do this, you know, like, so this.
Okay.
There was more stuff to shoot in this one than there is in the typical 5-on-5.
So, right? I was thinking more like, I think when I'm thinking of the 5-on-5 stuff, it's a lot of planning, and then pops off, and then it's kind of over really quickly. This seems just more like a, you know, co-op shooter, which I guess it kind of is. But yeah, I don't know. Something about this press conference didn't leave me super excited, maybe because I have no idea when any of those games are coming out either. Like, is Assassin's obviously this year, right?
Yeah.
And that For Honor, did it have a date or
anything? No, that's probably next year.
I think Siege is the only other one that's definitely confirmed.
Siege is
this
year.
And Just Dance, obviously. Yeah.
South Park is never.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I don't know. There's a games I'm excited about. But.
Yeah, solid stuff.
At some point, like, the thought that starts to creep in is just like, this is what we said about Watch Dogs the first time they showed it. Like, I don't know when that'll come out, but it sure looks awesome. Like,
yeah.
Okay, are they doing it to us again? We should probably really think this through. But, yeah. So I guess that's it for Ubisoft.
Hour Sony and a half till Sony.
Yeah. We'll be back at we'll be back in an hour to get ready for Sony.
I'm gonna get caffeinated.
Yeah,
and ready.
That's right.
Woo!
We'll get ready for some virtual reality Trackmania.
If Sony hits it, pulls out the Morpheus, that'll be the first full on guy with goggles on a stage, right?
So far,
HoloLens.
All right.
That's the one. Those are HoloLens.
Those
count.
Those are, yeah.
That's AR, dogs. Man.
Yeah.
Don't
yeah.
confuse them.
Yeah.
Still a headset.
So that's, you know, there was that Wired story this morning that kind of tipped the hand about some of the Morpheus stuff.
Right.
You know, just coming along. A handful of demos, but, like, some proper games, too, so.
You know what else about Ubisoft that kind of ticked me off?
What?
Was, like, on the heels of all, like, the kind of Available Now stuff, I feel like they... any other year, I know they do it every year. They're like, play it at a booth, but the lead up to that for like four of their announcements
that was lousy.
Just seemed like
when everyone else is like got something that is kind of happening right now
and a big surprise
playing to the home crowd, like
you can go watch us play somebody demo it.
Yeah, like okay, that's a bad surprise.
I thought
guys.
He was about to say it's free to play and it's out now.
Yeah. So, yeah. I don't know.
Well, that's a weird thing too, because I think we keep talking about is how the publishers are getting away from courting press to write previews and give hands-on impressions. That's the way this was working now. It's just skip us and give it right to the player.
Yeah, we can hide in our little room and talk about it from a distance.
But if they're saying the hot shit is that people like us are going to get to go play it on the show floor, if I'm a consumer at home and meanwhile Bethesda is giving me cool apps, I'm tuned out.
Totally.
The lucky few. it's just weird messaging.
Yeah.
I know. I'm excited for Sony.
Yeah, we'll see what they got. Those are always the big press conferences, right? So
let's do it.
We'll be back in an hour. That's 5:30 Pacific Daylight Time to start revving up for Sony. So come back and see us, all right? We'll be back.